Hi everybody, this is Miguelangelo Rosario from Berlin. I'm standing... Where am I standing? This looks like a telephone box to me. Okay, this is a scene I have built for to teach people to use the tool Tilt Brush. Tilt Brush is a virtual reality painting and 3D program, and I'll show you how to use it. And this is a scene that I've built, yeah, to bring new people in it and to show the creativity that we could release in VR. So I'm playing this as if I would be a newbie, so if I do little mistakes, they're on purpose. Okay, we have a menu. And we have something that looks like a laser. Okay. On this menu, we have teleport. And the show begins. Oh, flat. Ah, okay. Let me look around. Not gonna go in there. This is brought to you by LivePeerTV. Okay. Lots of stuff going on here. Okay, got a to-do list. Never wake up the android. I won't do that. So I'd rather shut up now. Okay, that's easy. got it. That's the fun part. You just take stuff and throw it away. Take it and throw it away. Even the menu, shake it and throw it away. So we're gonna use a little bit of the eraser to get rid of this. I come back. Let me see what's happening here. Okay, we have a mark on this. Okay, controller is done. Select. Let's see, where do we have select? this to go back to the eraser. Too much paprika.
Oh. Wow, psychedelic.
Too much. Excuse me? Too much caipirinha. Heavy stuff. Give it some magic. Some more magic. Okay. Hotspot number 3. So where else do we have hotspots? Let me see. Brings us to the next quest, which is to get some props from Poli. Okay, how do we do this? Go to the Poli library and see what's in it. Okay, I think this one fits. Scale it. Remember, scale objects, when they're active, they glow, and with the side grips here, you can scale things. And with the top bottom, you could snap them, so they stay horizontal or vertical. And when you want to pin it, hold it in place and trigger, and you see the pin. Now you cannot move the thing anymore. To untrigger it, trigger again and you unpin it. This one pin for now. I think I saw some books. Did I see some books? Oh. The good thing about those menus is they follow you around. I can teleport around now. And this is always next to me. So I'm gonna teleport over. If I can get those hooks to fit. Scale them a little bit. And fit them. Okay. This looks funny there. Let's see what we got. Do we have this dude? Ah, there we go. Let's try some brushes on him. Let's get rid of this. And gone. All this. The eraser. Thank you. I think we're done in here. What else? Spots here. Seven hot spots. We had six. Okay. To learn how to scale things, because it makes life easier, and besides that, it's a lot of fun. Things could get really big. So, hot spot number 7. Oh. In there, take a look. Whoa. Whoa. Space. Whoa. Where the painting goes. If anybody put paint on here, stays nice and flat. You don't have to go three-dimensional. It's important for beginners, because to think in three dimensions sometimes could get really out of hand. So we have this little spot here. I'm not gonna paint a painting now, I'm just gonna show how to import a painting, which is quite fun. So there's this media library. So I follow paintings and images, all kinds of stuff. You put it in the import library and you could use it and import them. And let's see, how nice little painting here. Just for fun, we're gonna add some fanciness. Yet. Okay. Use camera. So So I saw it. Ah, yeah, here we go. Camera. That's easy. Okay. With the camera, we have different modes. We can do a video, 5-second animated GIF, an auto GIF where it moves around like this, and a regular snapshot. What we cannot do is selfies. It's a shame, but maybe we get an avatar system into the brush soon. That would be cool. So, make a photo. And we get another black out because it's saving the photo in 12 megabytes, which is really high resolution for prints. So, this looks like it's getting done and dusted in here. Brushes, and with my new surface trick, the surfaces all get nice and shiny and have all those cool reflections. I prefer to walk around the furniture, it's just more fun. I mean, one could walk through the walls. I could walk through the big bookshelf, it's virtual reality, but it's just more fun to imagine that the things are real. One good thing is you could scale it, but nobody could mess up because things you can throw around, they never reach the ground. Ah! And it's gone. You cannot touch it. It's gone. Oh! And of course it's back. Good old undo redo button, so if you make things disappear, undo is the best button, okay? So this looks like all those are props for the dream. That's where people can be creative. Because the dreams are all in this shelf and in the palette and in the brushes. So let's see if we can find a dream. Android stream anyways, and if do they dream of electric sheep? I guess yes. Are we prepared to enter?
Yes.
I think we learned all the brushes, so okay, let's go in there. Yes, we are prepared.
We will soon arrive at Chichiku Terminal. Please stand for JR Line, KL Line, and Subway.
Oh!
Thank you for taking
the moment. Should I go out
there? Oh! Oh.
Maybe I'm going to sit down a bit and enjoy. Oh, what's this? Oh, of course. Sheep. What else? Let's see. What's in there? Some here. Did I mention before that I love Ember?
I cannot get enough of them. Maestro Billy for his tracks. Now the fun part about toothbrush begins. There are some of the brushes here that don't make a lot of sense in the first place, but once you start to experiment with them, look like much. For the beginning, it looks like something that's really rough and abstract. But in real size, you teleport that. Rainbow. It still doesn't look like much. Okay. So why is this? Because it's just too small. So what we do is we select. Now we come back in real size. Oh. See what I mean? Okay, it's still abstract, but definitely